Hey everybody, this is Mike. Today is Easter 2014, and we're having dinner here at the house, me and my wife. One of the first things my wife ever got for me for Christmas was Julia Child's Mastering the Art of French Cooking, and I'm going to fix a recipe out of here, beef bourguignon, just like in the movie Julie and Julia. Last year we had a roast lamb, and I didn't care for it too much. I think I overcooked it a little bit. It was a little dry. I think next year we'll do a leg of lamb. But this year we're going to do beef bourguignon, and got all my ingredients together. Let's get started. Okay, so to start off with beef bourguignon, the first thing you want to do is simmer bacon lardoons in water for about 10 minutes. I use regular thick-cut bacon, and the purpose of simmering the bacon in water is to remove the smoky flavor. American sliced bacon is smoked, and in the absence of having non-smoked bacon, we have to use our regular 1 pound package products here, and that's how you remove the smokiness. This step is in the recipe, but I've already done that, and now we're gonna saute off the bacon in my Dutch oven, so let's get started. Okay, so I got 1 tablespoon of olive oil heating up on a medium temperature in my casserole dish here. And this is 6 ounces of bacon that was simmered off in water to remove that smoky flavor. So I'm gonna get this in there now. And we're gonna saute this for 2-3 minutes or until it gets really crispy. What we're doing is rendering the fat, which is going to be used to saute and brown the meat, which in this case is going to be a rump roast. Okay, so the bacon has rendered off a lot of its fat. I'm just gonna saute it a little bit more and get as much of the fat out as I can. And then what's left behind is the fat and olive oil that we're going to saute the rump roast cubes with. So let's go ahead and get that out of there. Okay, so I'm gonna get my rump roast cut up here into cubes. And I've got a plate sitting here to catch all of the pieces I'm cutting, because we wanna dry those pieces off. Now I'm gonna cut off some of this fat, which is real thick, because we don't want that much fat in our stew. I'm not gonna take it all off, but just the amount that is real thick right there. Okay. Just like that. Right here, right here. There we go. Discard that. Now, in Julia's recipe, she calls for 2-inch pieces, and that's what I'm going to do. 2-inch pieces, just like this. Okay.
2-inch. Doesn't have to be perfect. Okay. Okay, so there we go. I've got a little over 3 pounds of rump roast cubed up, ready to be sauteed off. Now, Julia's cookbook, she's very careful to point out the fact that this meat must be patted dry very carefully. Otherwise, it won't brown off. And believe you me, I've done it. So patting off and drying it is a very, very important step. Okay, so we're gonna start sauteing off this beef in this rendered bacon fat and olive oil. And you want to do this in batches so that you don't overcrowd the bottom of the pan. You want to keep a fairly high temperature for as long as you can. Caramelization on that beef already. I want to try to get all sides. Just finishing up sauteing all the pieces of rump roast off. And everything just looks fantastic. Doing it in little batches. This last batch has only got 5 pieces in it, but normally I would put a little bit more in there. But with this cast iron Dutch oven, I usually don't have a problem keeping temperatures. Okay, so the next step is to saute off the onions and carrots in this same fat. I may add a little more, which I think I'm going to. I don't think there's a whole lot of fat in there right now. And I'm going to turn up the heat just a bit. And we're going to saute this off. Okay, something very important has happened here while I've been sauteing the onions and the carrots. You'll notice that all the little brown bits have come up off the bottom of the pan. And that right there is all the goodness. That is the bacon, the olive oil, the meat, and the moisture from the onions and the carrots has lifted all of that goodness off the bottom of the pan and has sauteed itself onto the onions and carrots. This is one of several steps that is very, very important to the flavor layer of this dish. Okay. Now we're going to put this back in. And I'm going to save the juice. Okay, so now we got the beef back in the pan, and I've put in 2 tablespoons of flour, and that's gonna help add a little bit of a crust to the meat. We're gonna toss this around, and then we're gonna put this in a 450-degree oven for approximately 4 minutes. And that should do it. Right there. So let's get that in the oven. All right, so the recipe calls for 4 minutes in the oven, and then pull it out and give it a stir, and 4 more minutes. So let's pull that out, give it a stir. And we'll get it in there for 4 more minutes. Okay, so we've got the beef out of the oven, and now we're gonna add 3 cups of a full-bodied red wine. And what I'm using is this Beaujolais here. Julia gives several ideas about wine for her recipe in the book, and I've used this before, and this Beaujolais is really, really nice. So I'm going to put 3 cups of Beaujolais in. Okay. Now I'm going to put enough beef stock to just cover that meat. Don't know how much it's going to be, but it looks like it's going to be about 2 cups. Okay, so I got the casserole on the stove on a medium heat, and I'm going to add a tablespoon of tomato paste. Add 1/2 teaspoon of fresh thyme. And a crumbled bay leaf, which I have never seen done in a recipe, but there you go. 1 crumbled bay leaf. In addition, I'm gonna add back the onions and carrots that we sauteed off. And we're gonna bring all of this up to a simmer. Okay, right here I've got 2 cloves of garlic chopped up. And at this point, I'm gonna add a little bit of salt and a little bit of pepper. Salt and a little bit of pepper. Bring that up to a simmer. Once it comes to a simmer, then we're going to put it back into a 350 oven for 2.5 to 3 hours. I suspect in my oven it's going to be 2.5 because of the adjustment I made on my oven. I have my ovens run a little hot. And it looks like we're up to a simmer. So we're going to lid it and get it back in the oven. Okay, so now we're going to saute off the mushrooms for our recipe. And this can be found on page 513 of Julia's cookbook, Mastering the Art of French Cooking. We're going to start off on a medium-high heat with a tablespoon of olive oil and 2 tablespoons of butter. We're going to bring that up to temperature. Okay, this technique that Julia has in her cookbook is very specific. She says that the oil and the butter should come high temp just before it starts to smoke. And it's going to take 1/2 pound of mushrooms. So I'm going to do this in 2 batches because this is 1 pound of mushrooms that I've cut in half. And what she says is, during that high temp, when you're just kicking it around, the mushrooms are going to first absorb all of the liquid. And then at that point, they will start their browning process. After about 2 or 3 minutes, they'll start to release a little bit of moisture back into the pan. But I've done this a few times, and sure enough, it works out that way every time. So it's going to absorb all the liquid, and then in about 2 or 3 minutes it's going to release a little bit of it back and then start to brown. Okay, so this is right about where I want the mushrooms to be, so I'm going to take these out of the pan and get started on the second batch. Okay, so we're exactly at the 2.5 hour mark, and I'm gonna pull the fricassee out of the oven, because that is what we have here, is a fricassee. And we're gonna take a look at the meat and see where we're at on the tenderness. Okay, we're going to go ahead and add the mushrooms that we sauteed. Okay, so there you go, guys. Julia Child's beef bourguignon done my way.